Good evening, everyone. Good evening. Thank you for being here. First off, my name is Todd Henley. I'm the Recreation Director here for the City of Portsmouth. I'd like to welcome you all to tonight's input session. First off, I wanted to give a few introductions. Here with us tonight is Brad Zalecki from Pillar Design Studios, Peter Rice, Director of Public Works, as well as members of the Skate Park Blue Ribbon Committee. Maybe those who are on the committee could just raise your hands real quick. Excellent, thank you. And members of the Recreation Board. If anyone's on the Recreation Board that's here, could raise your hand. Thank you. I'd also like to welcome Mayor Beckstead, Councilor Kennedy, and Councilor McKechern here tonight. We will be given a short presentation from Brad.
And Councilor Huda.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't see you. Councilor Huda as well. We will be given a short presentation from Brad on some initial concepts for the master plan for the Stump Dump site, and specifically the skate park. What Brad is presenting tonight is just an idea of what can be created, but we're really here to learn your ideas and what you would like to see out of not only the skate park, but also the possibilities of what could coexist on this property. As you know, the City Council passed a motion to build a skate park and recreation field back in April, and we are now conducting this feasibility study and determining the scope of the project. That's where Brad and his company comes in. This project, depending on the full cost and what funds are available, will most likely be phased for construction. The first phase being that of the actual skate park and parking, and then additional phases to complete the rest of the site. I just want to also point out that this site will be one of the primary connections to the upcoming rail trail. We welcome all of your input on what you'd like to see here, what skating, biking, scooting elements you would want in the park, as well as big picture ideas for what's ahead for this site. I'm very excited to get this project moving forward, and I think this is a real opportunity for a multitude of recreation experiences. After Brad's presentation, there will be a chance to walk up to the microphone if you're here and speak, as well as those attending by Zoom to raise your virtual hand and give input as well. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Brad, please.
Check, check. Does this work? Is this working?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, I can't hear anything. All right, I am going to show you guys a quick little presentation, talk a little bit about myself and the company, what we've done, and ultimately I'm going to show you three concepts, master plan concepts, that will include skate parks, pump tracks, playgrounds, splash pads, and initial parking layouts for the Stump Dump site. These are just ideas based off of the first conversation that we had with the committee a couple weeks back. So we've had some input, but these are still just ideas, and today's idea is just to talk to you guys, have a roundtable discussion, and kind of decide in a direction, and we'll see where it goes from there. So I'm ready to share the screens. I will. Here we go. Okay, here we go. At any point, guys, I like these meetings to be more of a conversation, not just me standing here talking. So if there's at any point you guys have any questions, please raise your hand, all right? All right, a little bit about myself. Again, my name is Brad Zalecki. I'm the president of Pillar Design Studios, Pillar Skate Parks. I have been designing skate parks for about 20 years now. And been skating since I was 12. So we've got lots of experience. We've got well over 400 parks under our belt all over the US. And I would like to be able to bring some of my experience from my travels back here. A little bit of our approach. I never want to do anything twice. Now granted, an A-frame is an A-frame. A hubba is a hubba, a set of stairs is a set of stairs. But we pride ourselves in trying to do each one of those pieces different every single time, so we're not doing the same thing. For example, we're gonna be building a park in Dover in the spring. So I wanna make sure what we're building in Dover looks completely different than what we wanna do here, because I know this is gonna be closer, we're gonna travel, we're gonna skate both. So a big thing of what we try to do, guys, is really try to make it unique. And the best way for me to make it unique is to get ideas from you, from the community. That's what makes everything that we do truly unique. And now, when we have questions, do they need to come up here and talk into the mic, or can they just ask?
Do we have any?
The only wireless that we have is what
you
have.
Okay, here we go.
Who had a question?
I do.
Perfect.
Hello. I was wondering if there's a set layout for the Dover Park yet. Have you guys decided on something? Oh, awesome.
I'll show you the Dover design and here in a little bit. All right. So part of our process is talking about styles of parks, which we'll get into a little bit more also. But a lot of us, especially the older generation, we grew up skating nothing but stuff in the streets and mini ramps backyards. So I've taken my education, architectural engineering, landscape architecture, into the skateboard world. And we like to create as close to an urban situation as possible. Our stairs, I want them to mimic real stairs. You know, banks, we try to recreate things that we are skating around here. So if you guys have a skate spot here that you're always getting kicked out of, let's take a look at it. Let's measure it. Let's try to duplicate it if it's something you guys want to do. All right? So that's the type of information I'm looking for. Along with the style of designs, we are adding a large concrete impervious surface to a very open, well, right now is a big dirt spot. But water is one of our major concerns when we are designing and building a skate park. Water is the one thing that can really destroy concrete over time. So we want to make sure that we are controlling where this water goes. And we can do a lot of interesting things with that water, as in storing it, reusing it for irrigation. We can bring it into rain gardens, retention ponds, bioswales, help clean it before it gets back out into the system and moves on. So the green aspects of our designs are at the forefront of our minds when we're trying to think of all this. So no matter what the design looks like, I'm always thinking about drainage. I'm always thinking about drainage. Any questions so far? We all good? All right. So goals, visions. You know, I'm here to talk to you guys about what are your goals for this park? What do you want this to be for your community? And when we talk about goals, that really dictates the direction that we take the design. So we talked a little bit about goals in our earlier meeting that we had, which you'll see comes in the concepts. But that is something else I want to be asking again from you guys today is, what do you see your goals for this community park? Because this is not just a skate park. Remember, this is going to have other amenities in it, which is what we're going to be asking of you also today when it comes time for comments and questions. So what I'll do is I'm just going to roll through a couple of the large master plan parks that we've done in the past. You can see here San Antonio, Texas, skate park, parking, splash pads, playgrounds, zip lines, all kinds of different things all within one park system. And again, it's about the goal of the community and the goal of what you guys want this site to look like. So this was built in two phases. When we focus on the skate park itself, 13,000 square feet for phase one, 3,000 square feet for the second phase. Another concept, Atlantic Beach, North Carolina. 13,000 square foot skate park, mini putt-putt, restrooms, snack bars, shaded seating areas, splash pad, playground. So if you guys are thinking mini putt-putt, you know, that's an idea. Next idea was in Scottsdale, Arizona for the Salt River Indian community. We did a 16,000 square foot skate park in the back, soccer fields, baseball fields, and then their large boys and girls club. So obviously I did not design all that stuff, but that was part of the process, the goals of the site, that we wanted to incorporate all the pieces in together so they all work. Bridgetown, Barbados. 16,000 square foot phase one. They want to do a phase two up here higher on the hill, where we did a skate shop, where we did a snack spot, restrooms, and a large, we did a really big kind of large barbecue zone, where we've got some grills over here, some picnic tables. So it's more so of the community. This is a community gathering space where everybody comes in, and even the non-skaters come and hang out and watch the skateboarders. Now, granted, Barbados is a huge tourist town. So there's a lot of tourists that come in and skate for the day or for the weekend, and their parents need a place to sit. The non-users need a place to sit. So we always want to talk about and think about the non-users also, not just the people that are going to be using the park. All right? The last one I'll show you is going to be this park we did in Stockholm, Sweden, I think back in 2016 or so. We did a 20,000 square foot snake run bowl. They have a 30,000 square foot ditch. You guys like ditches? This is one of the biggest ones I've ever ridden, in a skate park at least. And then a center island that you really can't see here. It's kind of over here, which is all street elements that they came back in and they did intricate brickwork. And they added some ledges and some stairs and some handrails and some stuff like that. So you've got your ditch, you've got your street zone, and you've got your big bowl that starts at 3 feet in depth all the way down to a 18-foot capsule. All right, so this is the Dover design. 10,000 square feet. And like I said, I want to make sure that what we're going to do here is completely different than what we're doing in Dover. And I can show this again a little bit later if you guys want to get up here and take a closer look. But we're looking at like 4 foot tall quarter pipes, 2 foot tall quarter pipes, fun box hubbas, flat bars, another fun box over here, a couple ollie gaps, bank to flat bars, some entry banks, some slappy curbs, and kind of this cool little pocket love seat idea. So I want to make sure that what we're doing here, we're not doing here. All right? So get a quick look at this, and don't ask me to give you a fun box. All right, cool. All right, so now let's, when we start talking about questions, I want to see, like, I'm going to ask people to raise their hands, like, all right, what do you skate? You skating stairs, you skating rails, you skating ledges, you skating bowls. What is it that you guys want to skate? So we've got the urban street aspects of the park, which I will explain to the non-users, the non-skateboarders. The street urban parks are the landscape gaps, the stairs, the handrails, kind of spreading things out, kind of bringing the green aspect of the park into the skate park so that we are designing parks that necessarily aren't skate parks, but parks that we can skate. So I'm a big fan of spreading things out and bringing in the green aspect of things and kind of softening the concrete heat island effect. So that's one of the things that you'll see in a lot of our concepts coming up. The other kind of concept, the other end of skateboarding, is the transitional ends of things. This is Nashua, Front Royal, Virginia, Stockholm on the end. The more heavy, empty pool style skateboarding, the speed, that type of stuff. So we want to talk about, you know, do you want to see more transition? Do you want to see more street? Or are you looking for something that's a little bit, I guess I don't have the 50-50 aspect of things. We want to mix them together. Those are all things we can do. One of the other things that was asked of me during our previous meeting was to incorporate some sort of pump track idea. So pump tracks can be dirt, they can be asphalt, they can be concrete. I prefer concrete because that lasts a lot longer. And we can tie it into the skate park and we don't have that asphalt to concrete connection that doesn't bother a biker at all, but it bothers a skateboarder a lot. So asphalt and concrete settle at different rates, so we want to make sure that we have good, clean connections to everything. So this is something else that you will see in the concepts that I'll be presenting. Some other aspects that were asked of me during the public meeting, the previous one, were to add some kind of playground into the mix. And when it comes to a playground, you have thousands and thousands and thousands of options. I'm just simply showing a couple different ideas here that you will also see through our concepts. So we're going to be asking, you know, not only on the skate aspect of things, but on the non-skate aspect of things of what do you want to see within this park. Splash pads, another idea. A great place for the skateboarder to take a shower after they've skated all day. The main thing that we want to do when we're incorporating skateboarding into the non-traditional or more traditional playground type of stuff is that we have safe separation. We have good separation from everybody. And may that be through landscaping, through berming, through just how we place it on the site. We want to make sure that there's nobody from the splash pad running into the skate park, or no one from the playground that's just going to get loose and run into the skate park. We want to make sure that these different uses have good separation. Other things that we will be looking at throughout the design process and things to be adding are going to be obviously parking lots, drinking fountains, walking trails, and lighting. These are all the things that were asked of us in the previous meeting. So I wanted to make sure that I showed all these types of things in our concepts. So I can do one of two things. I can run you through the plan view and a couple images of each one, or I can just maybe start with a video fly through of each one. And then, you know what, I'm gonna do the video fly through, and then I'm gonna show you this so we can make, I guess I'll do all of them because we have to come up here and talk in the mic. So that kind of throws a little bit of a wrench in here, but let me switch modes here and put up the videos because I'm gonna have to stop sharing. So sorry, those that are at home. And let me start with concept. I don't know which concept this is, but we will. Can you see it yet? Nope. All right.
There you go.
All right. So I'm just going to let this play, guys. And just give everybody a second just to watch it. This zone here, we got a half soccer field, open green space idea, splash pads, playgrounds, parking, skate park, right-hand kidney, which was asked of me, so you'll see a right-hand kidney in every single one of these designs. Just different shapes. And you'll see a different option for a pump track in each design also. So we've got our little back and forth street zone here to here, pump track, completely separate bowl. I'm a big fan of separating the bowl from the rest of the park because it's a different style and people use it differently. So there'll be guys that will just show up just to skate the bowl, put their pads on, put their bags down, bring their music over, and that's where they hang out the whole time. So we want to make sure that we've got space for all that, seating, shade, all of that.
Brad, could you orient the folks in terms of where Middle Road is versus the railroad tracks?
Yep. So when we get done, so this one gets to the end here. So we've got Middle Road is once it stops spinning. Shade structure, interior seating. Pump track to the right. Over the kidney. Again, playground, splash pads, soccer fields. So this white stripe you'll see in each one of these concept guys, that represents the train tracks or the train track walk, the pathway. So middle road is going to be down here, and then we'll have the entrance off of this. So we've got, and each one you'll also notice, because one of the things that was asked of me was to show the skate park in different locations. So in this concept, the skate park is in the back of the property, the farthest aspect of the park, with the separation of landscaping, play, and then open green space closest to middle road. All right, so I'm going to stop sharing and I'm going to pull up the next one. So that's concept A. Here comes concept B. So again, middle road, train tracks, skate parks in the front of the site, separated by big green space, play, parking. Completely separate pump track, not connected to the skate park whatsoever. A little bit of a different shaped kidney. Again, an interior center island for spectator viewing and shade. Separated by the green space, so we're keeping the kids away from the skate park, at least the kids that don't want to be by the skate park. And then the parking at the farthest end of the site, which is where we plan on intending on having the connection to the trail system. This one has a walking trail all the way around the site. You'll see that by this sidewalk coming out and around. So mom wants to do a couple hot laps while Junior's in the spray pad and all the other kids are at the skate park. So this concept, a little bit more of a traditional skate park approach over on this side, more of the street, urban flat bars, ledges, stair sets, and then again, a completely separate bowl. And I'll be able to walk you guys through each one of these concepts when we get through this. So if you've got certain questions, I'll be able to zoom in on certain pieces and we can talk about it. All right, so there's the second concept. Third concept. Okay, here we go. Again, this design has the skate park closest to the road. I'm a fan of this because of drainage. This is where we're gonna drain the park. So if we put the skate park in the back, I've got a trench all the way along this and we're gonna lose elevation. So I'm a big fan of putting the skate park a little bit closer to the road, which I know a lot of you guys aren't. But in this situation, we've got the open grass field in the back, parking in the middle, play, water along the trail system, and then the skate park in the front. And this one has a pump track that connects to the entire skate park also, splitting it, street, transition. Big open entry plaza. Again, there's your kidney, there's your right-hand kidney. There's your pump track. Walking trail all the way around it. Again, it connects into the parking lot and into the play, and eventually we tie into the trail system along the railroad tracks. So those are the three concept guys. So let's now, I'll zoom out to the plan view. Stop sharing that, get back into our presentation. Share that. Okay. So that gets us back to the overall master plan idea. So at this point, what we'll do is, if anybody has any comments, do you want to have everybody come up to the mic? That'd be easier.
I can walk around with a mic. That might be
okay. Okay. So if anybody has questions, comments, I want you guys to let me know what you think about these ideas. You're not going to hurt my feelings. I've had people tearing apart my designs for 20 years. All right. So if there's something you don't like, let me know. I'm a big boy. I can handle it. If there's something that you do like, please let me know so that we can keep this in mind. If there's an overall theme that you really like, let me know. If there's things in the park that aren't here, this is your time to speak up. The last thing we want is for you guys to be quiet now and then chirp up on social media when we're building it. All right? So, concept A, who's got some questions?
Yeah, Rich Duddy from the Rec Board and the Blue Ribbon Committee. Brad and or Peter, on the three designs with the one in the front, is that going to be based on core drilling plus drainage? Or why would you go to the front other than those two options? Are those the two best options?
Yes, the geotech report. And the geotech report is the subsurface exploration where we're going to find out what's below the ground. This is called the stump dump, meaning this site is filled with old tree stumps. Tree stumps are organic. Over time, they will disintegrate and go away, which leaves voids in the ground, which causes settling. We do not want that underneath our skate park because then our skate park will crack. So the geotech report is the number one thing that we're going to be looking at when we actually have to locate the skate park. Now, we want to hear from you that if you would like to have the skate park in the back and why you would like that versus the front. And that's up to the geotech. In my opinion, just by the site, let's just say the whole site is good to build a park. I would like the front of the site, closest to the road, this corner, because this is our low spot on the site, which is where we want to drain the water. So unless if I'm going to run power to the drains and have a sump system that needs to be maintained, then I need to be able to gravity drain the entire skate park. And we have the fall here. So if I build the skate park here, that means I've got to run a trench and a drain line all the way over to here, which means I'm going to lose 3, 4, 5 feet of depth. So if you want a 10-foot deep bowl, that's going to be a lot more difficult in the back of the site because I'm going to have to build up 8 feet. We don't want to do that. So it's a little bit better for the cost aspect. We can get more skate park if we're down in this direction because of the drainage costs. Yes, ma'am.
Jackie Callie Pitts, Rec Board. I'm not a skateboarder, and I don't know much about it except from watching it on TV and seeing it on the streets in New York. I like the front concept, but one of the things that I haven't seen in this is, and I'm not fixated, is facilities and where exactly your lighting is going to be. Is the whole area going to be lit or just a piece of the lit of it lit? And I like the front. I think the proximity to the road is better for the city, better for the people who use the park. So, but I don't see those two things, and those are important to me.
You are correct. Those are not in here because they weren't really a high talking point in our first meeting. We were looking for the larger skate park because lighting can get quite expensive, so can restrooms. But that does not mean that we're not going to have them. This could be a part of a phase two process, and that's a big reason why we're having this meeting today. So restrooms and lights are on the list. I can definitely add that into the next phase of the design. What's going to be lit? That is also a roundtable discussion. What do you guys, as a city, typically have for your park hours? Are all your parks lit? Are they dusk to dawn parks? Are they open till 10? These are all questions that we will ask, and that will determine what's lit and what's not and how long it will be. So still up for discussion. Did that answer your question?
Thank you. Yeah.
Did I answer your question in full? Perfect. Who else has got something?
Hi, my name's Roy Halsall. I live here on Middle Road. But what surprises me is that family people aren't here. The parents of kids in school that should be here for this, and then they're not here. And the ones that are against the skaters being on the streets and sidewalks, they're not here either. So they should all have been here to see what the concept is. That's all I have to say.
They may be home on Zoom, sitting on their couch.
Also, I think the middle school back to school night is tonight, unfortunately. So there might be some people who couldn't make it because of that.
Hi. Just a quick little rebuttal. I'm a parent of two little ones, and I actually live on the Plains, right next to the Plains playground. Kudos to Rec and DPW. You maintain it. It's a wonderful facility. Thank you. I do agree that there needs to be some thought into the what you've been referring to as the non-users. Some of the things that excite me, sorry, I'm winded from running to that mic, that there's going to be open space, and also that there's going to be connectivity to the rail trail. Most of our neighbors in our neighborhood have lived there. They're lifelong residents of the neighborhood, and they don't even know about the rail trail. Also an older demographic, so I'm excited to see that there's going to be some seating and some places for people to come and watch. I think skateboarding is going to be a great way to kind of connect the different demographics. I also work in recreation, and I like when I saw, I think it was the second one, where there's a little bit of a buffer in between the playground and the skate park, only because some of the things we deal with in the community I work in is when you cross over the demographics of people with little kids and older kids, people get upset about loud music and swearing. So it might just kind of be a nice deterrent to have the two with some space in between, but also close enough where I could bring my littles over to watch these guys skate and all that. So that's my input. Thank you.
And we can also create, you know, we can have a buffer, noise buffer with landscaping also. So undulating grass, trees, bushes, then that will help separate enough for the buffer the noise, but still be close enough for you to be able to see both sides.
Brad, we have some people online that would like to ask questions too. Could we, Michael Durhammer had his hand up. Kevin, if you can get that person's voice.
Hello, just checking, am I heard?
Yep, go ahead.
Brad, thank you for supplying three options. This looks really good. I am a skater, and to address the point that someone made, I'm also the parent of a middle schooler. That's why I'm here. We are listening. I like having the skate park closest to the road. I think that would give the best light pollution and noise pollution mitigation for the people nearest. I know when I bomb dropper ollie, it's very loud. So having that close to the road is better. I also like the drainage. I like the access to the rail trail as well. Some great work there. I see the shading elements. Is it possible that we can put solar collection on there to regain a little bit of savings for the city in general?
Absolutely. I mean, all that type of stuff, the design of the shade structures are 100% open. And we can definitely look into any kind of solar and any kind of green aspects that will help bring some money back to the park, back to the city.
I like what I see, and yeah, keep it close to the road. And the only other thing that I would maybe speak about is the multiplicity of ball fields in the town. We don't necessarily need another. I know that might be an unpopular opinion. I would be just as happy with an open field. And that's about it for me. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Lucia von Lep, I'm going to butcher it. Lucia. I can't pronounce the last name.
Yes. It's Lucia von Letkemann. It's okay.
All right.
I just want to say I'm also at home. I know there's a lot of people watching from home, so it is definitely easier for parents with kids, especially small ones, to do it this way. So I'm grateful that we can. These plans all look amazing. I too am a fan of doing it closer to the road. I love that we're going to tie in the rail trail and have a walking path around it as well. As someone else mentioned, that brings in an older demographic who just has a nice paved place to walk that's not right along the traffic. The pump track is exciting. All of this just looks so great. I love the idea of having a splash pad or a really cool new playground for kids at. And also the point of having a little bit of a buffer between the littles and the bigs is generally a good call. They can cross over and watch or interact if they want, but having a little bit of a break is a great plan. I'm just really excited for all of these. So thank you guys so much for doing this work, and I'm still looking forward to what comes about.
Thank you. Want to come back to here?
Yeah,
right, we got a couple here. Go ahead.
Thank you. Paul Mandel, 1490 Islington Street. This is my neighborhood. Can you put up the, there you go. I'm a B and C guy. I'd rather have the skate park where the green space is now. I love the straightforward parking in this part, whereas the parking is not separating the activity fields. Personally, I don't know how a half soccer field is going to get any use in the town. It may. I don't see it happening. I'd rather see a larger skateboard park by the road with green space separating it, call it an esplanade, call it whatever, between that and the splash area. And make the connections. If people are going to go off to the rail trail, they'll park here and they'll walk through green space to get to the rail trail. I mean, they're not driving their car to the rail trail. But so far, I mean, these are very exciting. Thank you.
Okay. We got a question over here.
I'll work this way.
Oh, thanks. Hi. Just to introduce myself to everybody, my name's Ian. I'm opening Voyager Skate Shop on Daniel Street. Nice to be a part of this community here. I had a couple questions, concerns. As far as the separation goes between the parks, I was thinking that personally, I'm more of a fan of the pump track, if there's going to be a pump track, being like disconnected from the skate park, because the pump tracks that I've seen in my, 20 years skating tend to attract younger kids, mountain bikes, people who aren't going to be skating the skate park, and it tends to create a bit of a mashup of like littles and bigger, older people skating that can get a little dangerous. So if those things could try like be a little bit more separated, I think that would be better overall for like the design of the park. And then additionally, it looks like every design does have some like shade structures and like seating structures, but I was gonna say that is something that I would like to see, because a lot of parks get built and then like in the middle of the summer, you can be there for a half an hour, an hour before you're toast, because there's nowhere to, nowhere else to be. And as far as what is the square footage of the skate park right now that's kind of been allotted roughly?
Right now, we're talking somewhere in between 15 to 20,000 square feet.
Okay.
And that really depends on what else we're going to spend the money on. Shade structures,
mm-hmm.
If we want to have the shade structures, we want the drinking fountains. What we want included in phase one is really going to determine how big the skate park is.
Cool.
So right now we're between 15. The first one was 15. This one is 17. The last one is 19,000 square feet.
Okay, cool. Yeah, that's what I wanted to know. I think that's about it. Thank you.
Okay, got a question over here.
So while we're passing, we have Seamus Durkin online that would like to ask some questions. Chris, hold on one sec.
Yep. Hi, I'm Seamus Durkin, 564 Middle Street. My only concern with the park was the pump track, because I was wondering how much use that would really get. I forget his name, but whoever said that it should be disconnected if we do have it, I agree with him, because it does attract some people that aren't really using the rest of the park. I was thinking maybe if we do have it, it could be in like phase two or something.
Okay, thank you.
Can I just ask a clarifying question? When you talked about square footage, are you talking about just the skate park, not the
When I talk about square footage, and my last comment was straight up skatable concrete. So that does not include landscaping, doesn't include any of the center islands. It doesn't include, that is just skate park. Has nothing to do with entrances or anything like that.
Chris Rice, Portsmouth. I'm on the skateboard park committee. On A, could that be flip-flop so that the skateboard park is in the front?
Absolutely.
The concept of the parking lot being the length of it, but still keeping everything separate, because like we talked about, the ground in the front's probably better,
yep.
And to save money on that, like, so that design, and at the same time, elements of all the designs can be combined into.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Yes. So all this stuff is movable. We can, if we decide that we want the skate park in the front, and you want the green space in the middle, and the play stuff in the back, and a long linear parking to help separate the active use from the residential, that's all doable. This is kind of why we're doing this process here. So this is the master plan aspect of it, and every single one of these concepts can be custom fit to what we're looking to do. So any other questions about this one, or I can move on to the next one. We can still ask questions.
Just a quick comment, Kelsey Sullivan, mom of a skater. First of all, thank you to the committee and the design. I mean, this is so important for the community, and I'm super grateful that you guys have all pushed this forward as quickly as you have. Just a couple of things. I mean, obviously, it's important that there are other elements, such as the splash pad, the playground, for potentially a way to monetize. I think more importantly, to help the community understand what the sport is and really sort of bridge that gap. So I think all of these things are important. But in the midst of designing it, I don't want us to lose sight of the fact that we're designing a skate park and adding these things as an adjunct, right? So some of the comments have given me a little pause on some, you know, creeping of the scope of this project to become so big such that we lose sight of making the skate park the hub and the other things are nice to haves. So, right, like be super thoughtful about what those amenities are. Is the splash pad exponentially more costly to build than a playground? Maybe that helps make our decision. So I just think just at every step, reminding ourselves that the skate park is the thing we don't have in this community, what is why we are here, and the other things are nice to haves, and what's truly important to build and what's not.
Yep. The purpose of this meeting is to talk about master plan idea, the goal over many, many years, but the phase one is the skate park. So ultimately, as I look at all the skateboarders out here, we still need to talk about the ins and outs of the concepts and what they would like to see also. So I know we haven't talked much skateboarding as of yet,
so
but that is part of this process.
I also just want to clarify too, as I said in the intro, that the motion that was passed by the city council was for a skate park and recreation field. So the skate park is definitely portion one, and then, you know, the recreation field and the other things that can come with that is definitely going to, you know, we're looking at that as portion, you know, phase two and beyond. So just to clarify.
Peter, do you have someone?
Yes, Brooks Pollock, first time speaker, and then Mike Durhammer has a second, but if we could go to Brooks first.
Yep, you guys hear me?
Yep.
My name is Brooks Pollock, live at Hillside Drive. I grew up skateboarding, and I got two little boys, 7 and 3, who are very into the sport. Love the idea, what you guys are doing. Thank you for all the hard work. I really like concept number 3. I like having the skate park in the front, especially that seems like the best use as far as design for it. I think a pump track is really important, but I did like the idea of separating it somewhat from the skate park. The gentleman that mentioned that, I think that's a great point. You know, I think that will draw a lot of little kids, and I think that's a good place for younger kids to learn the concept of skating. The green space aspect, I know that I feel like this town does need more green space for sports, soccer, whatnot. Yes, we do have the new field, but I know that's still pretty full. My thing would be how much green space is allocated, what could actually go there, and could it be put to good use? I'm sure that's things that all be thought of. And then as far as, you know, second phase, third phase, the playground area, I really like the idea of a nature-based playground. My kids go to Dundero, and they've been working on a nature-based playground. I think that'd be a good fit for this city. And as far as a splash pad, even me with little kids, yes, my kids might be a little bit older for a splash pad. I know those probably aren't that cheap to build. I just don't know if that's much of a draw as a bigger playground, bigger skate park, bigger green space might be. And thank you guys for all your hard work.
Thank you.
And then Michael Durhammer.
Mic check.
You're good, Mike.
All right. Just like Brooke said, I am pro pump track. I'd like to see that included high up in the pecking order, maybe not phase one necessarily, but definitely included. So far as the positioning, I'm agnostic, but I do want one there. And I agree as well that a nature-based or somehow a little bit more natural looking playground is great. Embankment, some of the dirt removal would be great to have a mounted slide, things like that look very nice. I did want to ask, and it might've been addressed, pardon if I missed it, what is the overall durability? I know concrete is great, but it does age eventually. How long will a skate park like this last?
Well, we've got parks that have been in the ground for 20 years. Plus, there are parks that have been here since the 70s. And concrete mix design has come a long way since those parks were done. So at this point, the skate parks are going to last as long as we take care of them. And it is our job to make sure that we're helping control the cracking, because it is concrete, it is going to crack. It is our job to engineer and to design and build these parks to last as long as possible. So 20 years plus is an easy guess. And a big part of the longevity of the park, again, guys, like I mentioned in the beginning of this, is the drainage, is the water, keeping the park high and dry. Does that answer your question?
All right. Absolutely does. Thank you for addressing that.
No problem.
I got a question. My name is Kenny Whedon. I'm from Barrington. I'm not part of a committee or anything. I just kind of showed up here. But as far as whatever you guys end up going with, I'm definitely a fan of kind of having a mixture of all styles. But that being said, it's definitely important not to overlook like street for sure. And that being said, this is kind of a petty input, but I would really hope for multiple round rails, perhaps even taking priority over square and flat bars. And one other thing I'd like to mention, I was at a park in Burlington and they had like kind of like a cubby like system or thing that was made out of concrete where people stored a lot of their phones, their waters, the waters wouldn't get hot from the sun. And I think that's a pretty genius idea. Of course, you probably can't like prevent theft, I suppose. But for people who don't care about their phones, it would be a good idea, I thought.
Perfect.
Lockers would be pretty cool. I would carry around a key. All right, thank you.
Hello, I'm Ollie. I'm just a local skateboarder, but I think I have a solution to what you were saying before about keeping it dry. I don't know how much it would cost, but putting like a roof, just a roof structure on top to keep it dry when it rains so we could still skate, and put like a drainage system on the roof. And or maybe like solar panels or something.
Yep, those are all great ideas. That get super expensive, but 100% is doable if we want to talk about it and talk about a phase two idea. But water doesn't necessarily always just come from above. My worry is the water that's coming from below, and I want to keep the concrete dry even from underground. So that's a big part of our drainage system and keeping the park high and dry so water stays in and around and goes and stays away from the park. But a roof system is definitely a plus.
Dago McCachran, I'm on the council here. And Brad, thank you for pulling all this together. Looks great. And thanks for everybody that showed up and made this better. I guess just first on the, I think there was a comment on, you know, whether or not a field is really useful there. I would love to see the process on the skate park, focus on the skate park itself as much as we can. And then I think another person made a comment, if we have a lot of, we have a lot of fields, it would be great kind of to keep the committee going to see, you know, further down the line, if, you know, if a pump track doesn't make it into here, if there's other, you know, other parts of the city that could be, you know, beneficial from a pump track, maybe not necessarily just have it right here. And then finally, just a process question. There's been so many great ideas that have come up, but I, as a parent of young kids myself, I know that there's probably a lot of people that are going to be catching the recording of the Zoom. Is there any way, and if you're going to go into this further down the line, but to have, you know, elicit feedback of somebody that does kind of spend the time and watch the video and want to share their comments, but maybe, you know, technical difficulties, the baby won't stop crying, to go off mute, to raise their hand, any number of, you know, reasons why they're not here tonight, but to be able to provide feedback in a structured way going forward to try to kind of collate some of this?
Yeah, I'll just say, Daylen, that, you know, anyone can contact me, email me, call me in my office, and I'd be willing to take all that information, compile it, and send it over to Brad. Not a problem.
I also have no problem giving out my email address, but we like to keep things streamlined and run everything through the city, and then that comes to me. That way we're all talking about the same idea.
I have a comment about the different area seating areas, and there's different seating areas in each design. And as a spectator, you know, I don't often like to have to walk through the park to sit down to watch, because I don't want to get in anyone's way. I'm not scared of being hit or anything, because most people know what they're doing out there, but I don't want to get in anyone's way. So I do see a need for, you know, seating in the middle, maybe for the skaters. And then they can be all together when they're sitting down and stuff. But I think it would also be great to have spectator area on the outside of the park too. And I don't know if I saw that or not. You might have put it in there.
This concept here, we got seating at the entrance.
Yeah.
Secondary seating over by the playgrounds. No internal seating.
Right. I guess it would be cool if there were both.
Yep, 100%. In this idea here, we could do some central seating. We could do some exterior seating in between the two pump tracks so that you don't actually have to step foot in.
Yeah, and I love the idea of the cubbies too. I thought that was... Yeah.
And the same as with the first concept is that we've got some internal seating. We could have some external shaded seating right along that sidewalk also.
Thank you.
My name is Michelle Flynn. I live here in Portsmouth, and my son's a skateboarder. There's a couple things. I love the idea of the park at the front, nearer to the road, because I think that, to me, the fact that the skate park is out of town, I mean, I think it's something that should be in the middle of town, but it's out of town. So, but to think it, to have some visibility as people are coming to town, I love that idea. And also, as a parent, I think about visibility from the standpoint of safety. I would echo, and I know this is the master plan, which was great for you to qualify, Brad, but I do want the focus to be on the skate park and the square footage of the skate park. I would also say that my kid is like a fan of street skating, and there's a lot of elements of downtown Portsmouth that they are verboten to skate in, but they want to. So the plan, and I think the kids were saying the second plan is a lot of the street elements, and I think that, and I would echo what you said too about the Burlington Park, that to make that front and center. And I know we have some guys over here to my right that have thoughts, but are maybe a little shy about contributing to the conversation. But
we'll have a little bit of a raise your hand idea here in a minute. So we get mass comment.
So I know you came here to kind of get all of our opinions. I was wondering, based on what we've said and your own opinions, which one of the three is the best?
We haven't gotten there yet.
You have no idea? Okay.
No. Because I really haven't heard much about the actual skate park designs as of yet. I've heard a little bit about big ideas, but not about each concept. And we will get to that. Once we get through all the master plan questions and all that other stuff, we can have more conversations about skateboarding.
Hi, I'm Lauren Kranz again, Plains Avenue. I wanted to second what somebody said on the Zoom call about a nature-based playground, maybe something that kind of encourages families to engage with the rail trail, and thank the mom who reminded us of kind of like the spirit of what initiated all this. As a parent with littles, I'm starting to think as I'm learning more about like the skate culture, is there some way that maybe we do explore foregoing, say, a splash pad? That I love the idea, but would it completely overwhelm this area and the parking too? I wonder that. Is there a way that we could explore maybe kind of like a multi-generational piece, and maybe some of it is that open space that we've been talking about where like little kids could come and start to learn how to skate or ride their bikes? And oh, one question, parking. Is it the same in each, the amount of spaces?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
And the parking will be 100% determined on what the amenities are. So these are just ideas at this point. And to answer your question about beginners, each concept that we always come up with, we design for beginner all the way to the advanced. We want little Johnny to be able to learn and have some small stuff to learn on, but we also don't want little Johnny to get bored and move on to the next skate park. So we're gonna always design for progression. We always want people to progress, but we'll always have separate little areas for kids to learn on, you know, a nice little quarter pipe out here where the kids can have some flat space just to ride on their own. You know, we got a little bit of a ledge zone right here, flat bars, ledges, kind of separating the ideas. This is a little bit more of a speed aspect, a flow part of the park, and then again, a standalone separate bowl. So we try to separate the uses from beginner to advanced, but at the same time, make it all work together. The worst thing you can do to a skate park is make sure it doesn't flow. So we need to make sure that the entire park and all the pieces all connect. So if you don't want to push, you don't have to.
Can you hear me? Steve DiTrolio, middle-aged mediocre skater. I just want to say for the record, I like at first glance concept B and C. I like it closer to the road. My concern, touching on what some other people had mentioned, is the athletic field. And I just want to offer that if you look around town, we have these big grassy fields attached to all of our elementary schools. We have a big square grassy fenced area almost adjacent to this at the park and ride parking lot that gets under or not even utilized. I think if we just utilize some of our existing open spaces better, then we don't necessarily need, I mean, I'm not saying I'm against an open grassy area, but does it have to be sort of, you know, an official sort of half soccer field size? Maybe it could be something free form. I would hate for us to tie our hands in the design aspect of the skate park in order to put a grassy field there, which we already have all over town. So that's my suggestion.
And the way that I look at these open spaces, no matter what the shape is, I see it as a goal of the community. Let's say that if we're going to have a park of this size, this is a large enough park to host events. And if you've ever been to a skate event, we like to have tents. We like to have vendors. We like to have other things that we could use this large grass open area right next to the skate park for those types of ideas. So, you know, other things that we've used skate parks for are like art shows. You know, video premieres. There's definitely stuff that we have built, big concrete walls that are skatable on one side, the other side is vertical, where they do weekly movies on the back side, and it opens up to the big green field where everybody comes and sits and watches a 10 foot wide, 12 foot wide, 16 foot wide screen with a movie on it. So again, it's a goal idea, and I'm a big fan of open green space anywhere in and around the skate park for the possibility of a future event. But the shape does not need to be a rectangle, like you were saying.
Hi, thank you. Corey Clark, Essex Ave, in this neighborhood, also on the planning board. But yeah, a lot of great comments tonight. I'd also echo that I think it's good having the skate park up against the road for a bunch of reasons. Also, you know, as the dad of little kids, you know, unfortunately we lost a great indoor park in the seacoast that was set up really good for little kids and also big kids. And I would just echo that, you know, having that progression is huge. The pump track, I know people drive well over an hour to get to a pump track in the Seacoast. That is okay. So I know it's going to be a huge hit. So I do think it's needed. Another comment just on the pump track is curious to see. I know it's not a part of this scope, but there are the dirt jumps on the other side of the rail trail that are definitely going to be integrated whether we wanted to or not, because it's right there. The splash pad, my kids, if they're watching, they're going to be mad if I say this probably isn't the best spot for it in the town. You know, Pierce Island or something like that would be a much better location, I think, for something like that than this. But I think this is definitely a huge step in the right direction. So thank you, everyone, for all your hard work.
Hi, Kathy Cosgrove, 174 Echo Ave. I've got two kiddos in the Portsmouth school system. Not to take away from the overall skate park focus, but just looking at the master plan, I guess I want to go back to what Ms. Callie Pitt said about the facilities. To me as a parent, I can't imagine us building something and, you know, the phases aren't quite clear to me in terms of what would be in each phase, but I can't imagine putting in a park, a skate park, and not having facilities that folks can use.
Second, we gotta do the mic so you can, everyone can hear you at home. I'll come back right back to you.
All good.
That, Jackie Callie Pitts, that was me who said something about the facilities, but as I'm looking at this, I'm gonna speak for myself as a grandparent. I don't know what you're talking about when you talk about pump truck, whatever. I don't know, except from watching skateboard and being in awe and terrified for the people who are doing it. But grandparents also like to come out and watch the children and watch their grandchildren. So I was wondering about some maybe some areas where people who are disabled or have trouble walking can get out there to watch, and shaded areas where older people could sit and watch. To me, that's extremely important, so that you have multi-generational. You know, telling me to climb a bleacher right now is like, okay, bring me to Mount Everest. But I hope that's going to be a consideration where you could say even a disabled child could come out and watch, where you could push a wheelchair or get to the facility to watch.
We will provide ADA access to all spectator seating areas throughout the site. We don't need to make it ADA access into the actual skate park itself, because there's no playgrounds that you have ADA access to the slide. But we will have ADA access to spectator viewing areas.
My name is Ryan Clark. I'm a skateboarder. I live in Portsmouth here. And I just wanted to say that the playground, maybe spending a ton of money and ton of time on the playground, isn't as important as maybe the other aspects, because right across the street at Plains Baseball Field, there's a big, nice playground, and that's all I just wanted to say.
We got one more.
Steve Parsons, Essex Ave. I have a 4-year-old and a 6-year-old, and they're pretty adventurous, and we're right down the street from here. And you're lucky if you get 2 months out of a splash pad during the year. I just don't see the cost benefit where we could get, like a pump track in the back separated by a field would be better. And people are probably going to be using this parking as a jump-off point for getting on the rail trail at some point in the future. So a totally separated pump track from this area could be beneficial on a phase two. Both my kids are already on skateboards, and I think investing in the park itself is the first goal.
Okay. Thank you. Are there any other questions before we start talking about skateboarding and we lose everybody else here that does not ride a skateboard?
Thank you. Hello, Will Mazzari from, I live in Elliott. I just wanted to say I really like design 2 and design 3. I think design 3 personally and for what I know of all the skaters in this area would be better if it had a couple more street obstacles introduced, but definitely design 2 and design 3 look better in my opinion from what I think everyone in this community would enjoy as well. Also really like grills. I feel like it just makes it more of like a community aspect where like someone brings a pack of hamburgers and then everyone's eaten. And then you can just stay longer. It seems more of like a chilled day instead of just go to the skate park for 20 minutes.
Okay. All right. So I think we can actually get into talking about each skate park. So now I'm going to want to go and I'm going to zoom in on each one of these designs. Are we done talking about everything else? Any other comments about restrooms, shade, seating, trails, soccer fields, nothing? Okay. We got one more. We got to record you what you're saying.
That's right. Certainly a number of people have expressed interest in possibly having musical events here. You know, some idea of space for a stage. Maybe it's in one of the open fields, but don't want to overlook the arts and how they're so tightly linked.
Okay.
Other interests that have come up that I've heard of, like having maybe the wall that we use, if we use it for screening for movies, maybe the other side, graffiti wall. Graffiti wall is definitely something that's come up.
Perfect. All right. All right, so this is the part of the meeting where anybody that doesn't want to talk about actual skateboarding, you're more than welcome to leave. Same with you that are at home that don't want to listen to us talk about something you have no idea what we're talking about. But what I'll do now is I'm going to get an overall feel from you guys from concept A. Everyone's taking a quick look at that one. Everyone's seen concept B. And everyone has seen concept C. So I want to see just by a raise of hands here. And anybody that is at home, I don't know if you can see people raising their hand at home, who likes concept A the best? Okay, and I'll take the mic. Where's the other mic at? Oh, do you want to give it to them? Let me know what you like.
Could you just show, I kind of can't tell what's...
Yes, absolutely. So here we go. I'm going to stop sharing, and I am going to get into the actual design. And I'm going to exit the video. Okay. Now I got to share it. My bad, I should have been doing that the whole time. Okay, here you go. What is it that you like or do not like about this concept?
The bowl is perfect.
Okay.
The street area is perfect. I know that the younger generation sitting to my left likes plan B a little bit better, but I think that the setup of this is perfect, and that's just my opinion, but the bowl is exactly what it should be.
You like this bowl better than the concept B, the squirrely one?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Who else raised their hand about this one? Did they like the A?
I'm on the skate park committee. My name is Jesse Court. And why I raised my hand for skate park A is because there are so many rails. And it's just there's a lot of options, like to flow around the park. You could hit the stair set, go to that flat bar or to that mani pad or to the box, then go right to that hip, or you could even hit that gap, that grass gap right there.
Yep, and you're more than welcome to come up here and point at the screen if you'd like to.
You
can interact.
All right, yeah, I'll get up. Is this a euro right here?
No, that's just a straight clean bank.
Just bank. All right, yeah, you could air off the side of this quarter right into that bank. You know, go down here, hit that rail. So I think skate park A overall is just so much more flowy.
Okay.
And right from there, you can just go right into the snake run.
I like it.
In my opinion, it's better.
Everybody has a different style. That's the big thing about us skateboarders. Everybody's got an ego. Everybody wants to ride what they want to ride. But we want to try to get something a little bit for everybody. So is there anybody here that – is there anything on this concept that you hate? I'd love to hear it. Nothing that you hate? Okay. Okay, let's hear it.
The spine should be all the way to the side.
This?
Yep.
You should go all the way to this way?
Yep.
The idea of that not going all the way over is to continue the pump track.
I see.
So the idea is that if we do a spine all the way across that, you come around this pump track.
I see.
And you're hauling at a spine.
Oh, yeah. You're not
hitting the spine. You can't ollie that spine.
Yeah.
There goes the pump track. Okay. There we go. All right. So that was A, okay? I'm going to ask B, I'm going to ask C, and then I'm going to have ask an overall from all the non-users also to raise your hand when we're done with this after you've heard everybody, okay?
I want to see which ollie you like, Jack.
All right, well, let me, let's see, can I even just jump to the next one? Probably not. I got to stop sharing. And I'm going to now share. I lost it. Why can I not open this now? Cancel. I can't open this now. Let's go. Let's see if I can do this. Is there a reason why I can't see this now? Go to this. Come on. There we go. All right, share screen. Concept B. All right, here comes concept B. Where is it? A, B. Let's talk about concept B. All right, let's see a raise of hands. Who likes concept B the best? If you want to come up, you want to come up and take a look at it, man, go for it. All right, so let's hear about what you guys liked about concept B the most.
Oh, all right, yeah. All right, I'm just going to get up here.
Yep.
All right, so I think in concept B here, it's got a good mix of, like, street-style elements here with, like, some ledges, some flat bars. I do like that there's a nice three-sided hip here. I do actually really love skating a hip, and there's been a lot of hips that come out more like a snowplow with, like, more, like acute angles that are, like, harder to skate. Kind of like the one at Amesbury. It's like, it's a fun hip, but you kind of like shoot over it. And like, I deck check the top of it a lot. I think that this is a good mix of like street elements that also has some transition in a kind of, a meaningful transition section here, as well as the kidney. But I think, you know, Chris was saying he preferred, I don't skate a lot of bowls or a ton of transition. I didn't grow up skating that, but it sounds like the bowl in the first design is better. But I was going to say that I moved to Exeter from Boston about a year ago. And a common thing that I feel like sometimes I hear with skate parks is like, oh, if you want a street ledge, like go to the streets. But like, since I moved up here, like there is not a street ledge to skate that is not a bust, that is something that I'm gonna like be able to go skate. So I would love to see stuff that is kind of like, you know, sometimes like a basic ledge is like overlooked in a skate park because it seems so obvious that it's like, oh, we want to skate something cooler than that. But I do love just like this ledge here, like as simple as it is, or this flat bar. I do actually, you know, I'm 32. I don't jump down stairs as much as I used to, but I still actually kind of like to do that, believe it or not. So I like that there are some stairs. I just think this one looks like the best blend of, you know, street focused with elements that are also going to satisfy like transition or bowl skaters. That's my two cents. Thanks.
Just one quick thing. I really do like the fact that the pump track is separate and doesn't really compromise the integrity of the core park. You know, it's something we could phase in independently of the core skate park. I'm growing more and more convinced over time that in many cases we're gonna have a different audience for the pump track that's independent of the core skate park. So I do like that aspect of it.
Is this the one with the half pipe kind of going off to the side, or was that three?
This piece right here. I don't have any mini ramps. What are we talking about?
Oh, I don't even know if that's what it's called.
Yeah, what do you think? What are you thinking of?
The thing that goes like this back and forth. That's in three.
Yeah. I think you're thinking of he has design three.
Oh, that's what I thought that was. To the right of the kidney. Yeah, that's just a like a ramp with stairs. Okay. Okay. All right.
No problem.
Sorry, I forgot one thing, and I'll shut up. I really like the that sort of volcanic stump like form. I think it's kind of a nice nod to the stump dump. So it's pretty cool.
There you go. You're the only one that's caught that so far.
Yeah, I guess I was a little confused. I wasn't sure if that was a mini ramp in the back. But yeah, thanks. Thanks for the clarification. I do think a mini ramp would be huge somewhere, kind of play on that progression from, you know, I just find, you know, mini ramps are kind of nice to people getting into it, little kids, that sort of thing. So
I tell you what, we're building one in Manchester and we're building one in Kennebunk.
Good to know.
Kennebunk is only 25 minutes away.
So I like this one as well. A couple features that I personally would like to see is a pole jam and your classic curb. And actually, if budget is like no concern, if we're going to keep it towards the street and not worry about drainage and sump pumps, a second section of just flat ground for like games of skate. So.
Yeah, so I mean, I was thinking like games of skate could happen, you know, on these two zones here on both sides of the spectator viewing. So you can sit in here, you can sit in the shade. Oh, I guess I should do it here. You sit in the shade and you can do games of skate here on your ledges, your mani pad, your ledge, or your flat bar. To me, that's my game of skate zone. I got a little bank to curb here. We call this the TD special, Mr. Thomas Dupree over here. But you're looking to have just a straight up slappy curb on flats, right? Okay. And a pole jam. Yep, those are very easy and cheap things to add. Okay, so this is B. Anything else about B? Yes, go ahead.
So this is my favorite design by far. I think it offers the most of everything while having the best flow. I had a couple critiques though. That small ledge that your mouse was on right there that's curved, I think that should be straight because it's a center point of the park, and curved ledges just don't get used as much because they tend to shoot you into the end and your shin is just like sketchy. Okay. You don't really,
I think that should be straight. And then if you pull the screen down a little bit, is the flat down rail curved on the flat part at the end? Or was I to the left? Yep, that one.
There's a pole jam on top of the fun box.
Yep, but to the left of that.
Oh, that's just a straight down rail.
But the, the way that it ends there, that I think that would be straight down, because if you're doing any bump to rail trick, that's just going to throw you off for a normal trick. And going straight on, you're never going to really wally up that, compared to it's just going to feel unnatural, where you're like, do I get on halfway on the up? Where it's like just straight down, in my opinion, would be much better.
Okay.
Is there anyone online? Anyone else?
Okay. All right, then I'm going to go to C. We're going to get that raise of hands. We'll talk about that. And then we're going to get an overall A, B, and C from the whole group so that we can see here. We can get a total count of hands, all right? So I'm going to stop sharing and move to the last one. All right, concept C. Let's see a raise of hands for who likes this one the most. Okay, so we don't really need to do the rest. I already know which one we like. So we got one guy in the back. All right, so let's hear what we don't, or what we do like. What is it that you do like back here? So I can add some of that into another idea.
I'm Rich Blaylock. I am on the skateboard committee. I'm also on the rec board. I like this because it's closer to the street and it would cost less money.
What about the skate park? Do you like anything about the skateability aspect of it? Okay. So just from my own knowledge here, no one raised their hand for this one. I want to know what it is that you guys don't like about this idea. All right, go ahead. I want to hear these things. This is from my own education.
My name is John Flynn, and I'm on the skate park committee. But I don't really like all that transition. Like, it's nice, but I feel like if it was my home skate park, I wouldn't want to just, like, be skating all the transition all day. And there's not really, like, a flat section where, like, there's, like, a rail or anything.
Okay.
No, there's no, like, round rail. But, yeah.
Okay. That's what I want to hear. Is there anybody else that wants to put any input on that?
So like right here, there's a stair set on both sides. So it kind of just like defeats the purpose.
One square, one round.
Yeah, actually that's true. But they're both like running into each other, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. You got about 50 feet of flat in between each.
True.
But the idea there was so that we could do either two different size round rails, like somebody asked over here, or we do a square rail and we do a round rail, just trying to give a little bit of variation, because there are a lot of people that I get yelled at a lot for square versus round and not doing both or only doing one or whatever. So anything else with this one, and then we'll kind of wrap this up.
No, mine was just, and sorry, a bit off topic, but in terms of the covered seating on choice B, which is what I think my kid's voting for, so I will as well, that's pretty expensive real estate to be putting seating. So I just would make the suggestion in B that maybe we pull it out to the perimeter. It's a lot cheaper to put it on mulch than concrete.
It doesn't make a difference in cost-wise. I would never do mulch next to a skate park.
Okay, not mulch, but like wasting that concrete square footage for
But we're not wasting the concrete square footage seating. Because I've got so much space, I can spread it all out. I like the center interior skate seating for games of skate, like I mentioned in that concept B. I'd want to sit in the shade. If I'm playing skate and I'm not skating, I'll sit down and watch. And I would like to have that internal shade. What we typically do not get in skate parks is shade for us. Shade for everybody else that's watching us. But as we're skating,
I like to have stuff inside the skate park also. But I understand where you're coming from.
Valid.
But we're not taking up valuable real estate because of how we're laying the design out.
Valid point. Yeah, I mean, precisely, we've flown all over the country to go to skate parks, and quite frankly, I don't think I've ever seen covered seating in the park. So kudos. Maybe it's we'll have the only one. Great idea. Anyone else?
Okay, so we're going to do one final thing so that we can see here and we can get a count. All right, are we? Is everyone paying attention? All right, I want to see a raise of hands for A. Okay, so it looks like they have convinced everybody. We know exactly what we're doing. Okay, raise of hands for B. I don't even think we're going to have to take any count. Raise hands for C. Okay, we're good. I know the direction we're going. You are more than welcome. We'll end this meeting. You guys are more than welcome to come up and talk. I will leave concept B up. We can have a little bit more of a discussion. And we'll go this direction with some tweaks, all right? And we can talk about the tweaks. We'll change the bowl. This pump track's gonna be a phase two. We'll look at the center island idea in the seating. Is there anything else in here that you guys really see that you really want changed or added?
I'll start back here. Thank you. Yeah, I just want like a Euro and like Will said, the bump to bar to be cut off and not a roll up.
Okay.
Definitely agree with the bowl. Should definitely be from the first design.
Okay.
That one's the best. And then definitely need to focus on having a flat, straight ledge with good ground in between that everyone can skate.
How tall would you like this ledge?
About a foot.
No way. That short?
Yep.
Come on.
Yep. 14.
All right.
Yeah, 12 14, to 14.
I like 14.
Because you want to be able to flip in and look at those kids over there. You think they're jumping on the 16-inch ledge, flipping in? Nah, they're trying to flip in on the 12.
So look, we've got three ledges here. We've got this ledge, we've got this ledge, and this ledge. So I can do an array of ideas.
Perfect.
We could do a mani pad. We could do like an 8, a 12, and a 14, or an 8, and a 13, and a 16. Whatever, we'll figure it out.
One more thing is, if you're going to do the curved ledge, I think it would be much better to do it on the side ones as compared to the one
we're
directly in the
out.
Center.
Yep, perfect. We'll straighten it out. All right.
Got some over here. I
definitely agree with Ollie on the Euro. And Ryder Field used to have this big Euro. I don't know if this would be possible, but It was a big Euro, and it would shoot you up, and it was just super clean. And I miss Euros a lot, so.
Okay, you got it.
Anyone else?
Could you put a pump bump on the flat, leading to that single quarter up next to the bowl? A pump bump in there.
You want to pump up here?
Yeah, just so you could have speed going in and out.
Yes, but I think it'd be in the way.
Okay.
In my personal opinion.
We have our tribute to the stump dump.
Yep, right here.
Oh, perfect.
We talked about this a little bit, is adding not bricks, but some dye to some of the crete to add a brick effect because there's so much brick within this town. And
yeah, we could do a stamped brick.
Yeah.
Putting real brick in is going to pop out over time, but we could do a stamp and we could throw color on it.
Yeah.
We could do that on a specific piece, you know, like in a corner to get that carved and that sound. We could do it maybe just like on a small bank right here. Ooh, does that go back and forth? It's kind of nice.
Brad, sorry, I just kind of missed that. What were you saying about potentially where you would maybe put like a stamped?
Well, that's kind of what I was looking at.
Because I was going to say, I love the like aesthetic of like tying in the town's bricks, etc. But like, in my opinion, I have skated many parks with like a stamped brick, and a lot of times I'm just like, oh, I wish this was smooth.
Right. That's why we put them in certain areas. All right,
cool.
That you don't really need the speed.
All right, perfect.
You're going more for the sound.
Cool. Yeah, yeah. Because, like, for instance, like, Hingham has that weird. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yep. And then do you think you could just zoom in one more time? Or, like, how annoying is that?
Nope. Just give me a second.
All right.
All right, what you looking at? What do you want me to zoom in on?
Yeah, well, I was just looking at this feature here. Right here, how Will was talking about. I know we talked about maybe getting rid of that, yep. But I was thinking some way to potentially make it. Because, like, I feel like here, like, people always want, like, one of these, like, little bump-to-bars. Mm-hmm. And then maybe this triangle piece here, like, because basically, like, this side is kind of like
unskatable,
right? Yeah. Absolutely. So maybe just create, like, shaving that off so that it's like, I don't know, but maybe just reconfiguring this section so that, like, this side isn't, like, wasted. And, you know, if or maybe this goes away and, like, a bump to flat bar is, like, in a, I don't know, but I just saw that and was like, oh, that side's probably wasted there.
Because I've got a bank to flat bar here, but it was just going to be smaller and it was going to be square.
Right. Yeah, so maybe, like, yeah,
and
okay.
I've got another round rail here in the back.
Yep.
A nice, mellow, small...
Yes.
Down flat bar?
Yep. So maybe, yeah, like, maybe that bump to bar in the side, like, maybe you don't necessarily need it. Although I do know, like,
that is one of the most popular things.
Yeah, people love that.
Yep. So feature, maybe we just rework this.
Yeah, maybe
this
just rework
right
the corner. Yeah. Okay, all right, cool.
Open that up.
Thank you.
Okay.
So that round down rail, yeah, that one. I don't know if this is possible, but, like, maybe we could extend it and make it, like, kinked somehow.
Kinked?
Yeah.
Man, you trying to hurt us? kink is a dangerous world. We can think about it. We can think about it.
I think the really long flat bar with the banks on both sides that's square,
mm-hmm.
almost has to be circle, because it's so much harder to lock into a 50 on a square rail because you have to balance on the rail, where if it's circle, your trucks can lock in and you can be moving from side to side and, like, regain your balance.
Do we want any square rails in this?
For me, no.
I'm looking. Anybody want a square? Microphone.
Also, we're like all young. We could get up and
I think you just use this one. I'm already walking around. Go ahead. All
right. So this isn't my opinion because I know most people don't like flat rails, but I find them easier to, like, lock in on. And on a very long rail, I feel like it's very easy to slip out on the rail like this. How long is it?
That's probably gonna be about 40 feet.
Heel side.
Do we need flat rails if we want to do any kind of competition?
Nope. Okay. I mean, it's 100% personal preference on round versus square. There's a lot more kids that skate round, a lot more. It is easier to lock in on for most people. But some people like square, and it's just a personal preference. That is it. But
I was just kind of wondering, with the new Dover skate park coming in, what they're doing with the old one? Are they tearing it down?
Yes.
Yep. So
we couldn't say if they move that when they move that mini ramp, the wood's just too rotted. So I'm sure they're gonna do something with it.
If we could have that.
Well, you have to talk to the city of Dover. I have no control over that one. Talk to the skateboarders there. I'm sure that they've got plans for it. I'm sure there's plans for that mini rant.
Hey, Brad, is this thing right here? This is basically like a Eurogap.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. I couldn't tell. So for the kids who are asking for a Eurogap, like there pretty much is one. Right
Both
there.
Sides.
Yeah. Cool. All right. That's it.
I swear, I'm probably done. I'll just let Will take care of it.
My only other argument with round rails versus square rails is if you're not at the skate park, in the streets trying to film a video part or doing something like that, most of the rails are going to be round. And if you were to do a square rail in the skate park, I would almost say it'd be better to do down a handrail or some stairs because it's fast and that's more what you're going to be skating in the street. I don't think I've ever skated a 40-foot long square bar in the street, but I've definitely skated round bars that long.
Okay.
Way more fun.
So I've got two sets of stairs here. I've got a big set, which will be, what do you guys think, 3-4 foot high? So that could be a 6 and 8 stair, something of that nature. So big set. Now, I've got two handrails going down here, but I've got them pushed off to the side. So you got front side, back side with round, because bigger set of stairs I would like to do round. We've got a little bit more of the beginner, small set of stairs. I could do that a square. Okay, any other? We got one more. We got another one back here. We got a couple more here.
On that set of stairs to the left,
yep.
Could one of the sets of stairs be made a bank ramp? Because it's essentially the same as a set of stairs, but then it kind of opens the park more.
I thought about that, like I did over here. I have a bank. But in my head, this is like your picture. This is your photo set of stairs. So your true front side, true back side, if you're approaching this, you're jumping.
Yeah.
Or if you're old, you're getting off your board and you're walking down it. I get it. 100% I get it. And another reason why I kind of didn't put a bank here is that crisscross. Lots of speed coming down this, people coming out here. At least with this, if you're jumping this set of stairs, you've got at least an idea of what you're doing. But yes, you're going to shoot your board out. Yes, there's going to be some collisions. Yes, we're going to have some crisscross. But I'm just trying to minimize it a little bit. And I personally, if we're going to do a set of stairs, I don't like putting them in the skate park. I like them like to the old man zone where guys are going to walk up there with their pads and their music, and they're going to come up here and they're going to chill, and that's their spot. So kind of keeping the speed away from going up and down and keeping the games of skate, like someone ollieing up the bank, shooting the board into the bowl. That kind of leaves that as its own zone.
How deep is the bowl?
That is 100% up for discussion. We're talking size, we're talking trannies, we're talking about depths, pool coping, tile, or steel. So we'll go to the bowl guys.
Hey, what's up? My name is Ryan. I live on Austin Street. I just had a quick question because, you know, you see like the Nashville Park has three bowls that are all pretty super steep. Mm-hmm. Good Ryer Airfield back in the day with a small, medium, and a bigger one. And I found that, like, even us as kids, we usually skate the smaller one, and
yep.
The bigger ones are always super, super intimidating, even for, like, the older guys. I just don't want to see the bowl get too deep and then absolutely have no use and be a complete waste of space.
What are you thinking?
Something. I suck, but, like, something pretty mellow for the, you know, I think would be beneficial to the community.
Okay.
For sure.
What is mellow?
8-foot bowl.
That's not so mellow.
Well, I mean,
no, but I would argue that you need, like, there has to be transition, right? Like,
oh, there's transition. There's plenty of transition in the park.
In terms of, I shouldn't say that. There needs to be a bowl, right? And so, like, bowl skaters want, like, 8 to 10 feet, right?
So, not everybody wants 8 to 10 feet.
My bowl skater does.
8 foot is fun.
Yeah.
No, we've got two levels in this bowl. There's going to have to be a shallow end and a deep end. If we were to do a 6-8 or a 5-8. You know, 5 shallow, 8 deep. That's doable. What are you thinking? This, I mean, the kidney is your baby. What are you thinking?
4 or 5 shallow, 6 or 7 deep.
Okay, so, okay.
I mean, if you're talking monetizing competitions, though, you're not having bowl competitions at 6 feet necessarily.
I mean, you can. You're not bringing in Tony Hawk to do 540s.
and listen, this is your world, not mine, but having these kids competing for the past couple years and like the Hot Wheels, the Nitro Games, the Grind for Life tours, they, you know, that we've been traveling to.
They got the bigger stuff.
I mean, I think we can have that here. We can bring those people here. We, you know, Hot Wheels at Rye was huge. Mm-hmm. And I think we just need to have a little foresight, if that's a goal, mm-hmm. that we have a bowl that can accommodate it.
Got it. It's all about the goal. Okay, what else? Anything else here, guys? We got some over here. Is there still people on here?
Yeah, but they haven't raised their hand. Brad, just, you know, remember, this is the only bite at the apple. Yeah. Now they'll have a chance to get input.
Well, I need all this input to actually put it in the next design.
Yeah, I get it.
Do we know what the schedule of this project's going to be? Or when this might happen?
I mean, the, you know, part of this whole process is getting, you know, the Brad's going to put this together, and then we'll get an idea of what the cost is going to be. And then at that point, you know, I think it has to go, we would have to identify funds. The city council will have to identify funds for that and go from there.
Because it looks like the stump dump is being used right now. Is that correct?
That is correct.
It is. It's being used for staging for city projects, but I met with them today, and they said they could be out of there within a week if necessary. So that work is not holding anything up.
Okay. I was just curious about that, seeing that there.
No.
So
the project, so just in general concept, once we have funds in place, a design has to be done. And Brad, you know, typically you got permitting, you got geotechnical work, you got, you know, final survey. You know, you got to put together a bid set. So there's a lot of work that needs to be done, and that takes months to do, probably close to 3/4 of a year, right? You know, plus or minus, depending upon the permitting challenges.
Yep.
So, you know, once we have funding in place, it still takes some time. So what Brad's doing right now is putting together a concept and coming up with an opinion of cost that we can then go to council, city council, to say, you know, put it into the CIP or appropriate money to be able to do this. So it's going to take a little while to implement.
Okay.
So, no. Meaning this probably isn't going to be built next year.
That's what I wanted to see if we could get to that part. But thank you.
We'll have Dover ready for you by the summer.
I just want to say something. As a city councilor that's walking around here, we're going to try, as soon as we get a figure, look at the funds, figure out funds we can potentially, in the motion we made, we can use state, federal, and local funds. There are federal funds out there. So we're trying to get a figure of where we're at. And at which point, Peter's right, we'll bring that figure to city council and say these would be the funds we're going to use for this project. Then you have the building time. So we're trying to figure out how much money something like this would cost.
So from here, guys, what the plan is that we're going to go back to the drawing table now that we've got an idea of scale and kind of what we're looking at. Now we need to really dig into the actual site. We need to start doing some geotech exploration and find out where we can put it, because where it's placed is going to depend on how much it's going to cost. So the first step is to come up with the idea. So I'm going to kind of somewhat finalize an idea that how are we going to be able to get that idea out to them? Do we want to do another public meeting? Do we want to just post it on the city website of what we're thinking?
We can probably discuss that and figure out what the best option is.
You know, stay in touch. Go, you know, look at our Instagram page, which is Pillar Skate Park. Stay in touch with the skate committee to find out more updates of what it's actually going to look like. And it's going to take us a little bit of time to get the site prepped and figure out where we're going to put it, place it, do the drainage ideas, put costs to what we may have to do with the remediation of the site. So we still have a lot of work to do, but today's meeting was to get the basic idea of what the skate park looks like so that we can start moving forward with all the other ideas. So, yeah.
I just have one more minor question about the ledges. Is there any way
you could do just the metal on the side as to provide for all concrete on the top for better sliding and more equal sliding as compared to just the metal on the top, or is that something that you don't
well,
do?
Well, we have done that in the past, and FYI, look, I got two more ledges here for you.
Perfect.
I have a total of 5 ledges.
Love that.
Okay?
Thank you.
So we can do lots of heights for that. Now, we have done just the vertical
on the
4 or 6 inch, and then just finished the concrete up to it. What happens is over time that concrete chips away and that edge is skated so much that it gets sharp. In those corners, someone falls and it will rip your arm apart.
Yep.
So we typically stick to our 2x2s or 2x6s. We like to keep at least a 2 inch top to it so it doesn't wear down and get sharp.
Cool. My one thing would be for the height of the ledge, I don't know how tall it is, but the height of the ledge at the barracks is perfect.
Okay, well, we've got 5 different ledges, so I'm going to have a whole different range from 6 inches to 14 or 16. All right, what else? Anything else?
This doesn't have to do with the park, but I just want to let everybody know that Dave and I here, we do a Facebook page, so if anybody wants up-to-date information, go to the Skate Park of Portsmouth Facebook page. We try our best to put, I think we put everything, all our meetings on there when they are and all that. And if, you know, we have a meeting next Monday, I think we'll have a meeting next Monday, I'm not sure. We'll recap what went on that meeting on our page. And then you can always get in touch with the Facebook page or with Todd if you have any questions. And if you get in touch with the Facebook page, we'll probably get in touch with Todd about it. So maybe the best way is just to get in touch with him. But yeah, connect with us on the Facebook page so you know when everything is happening.
Anything else?
Can I just thank Dave and Amy? They're our co-leaders of our skateboard park committee. And I want to thank Peter Rice and Todd for putting this together and you for coming. I personally would encourage us to have a public meeting and unveiling of our ideas. So I'm hoping we can maybe move forward with that so that you can all be part of that. It takes a village, and it takes a huge village to make a skateboard park. Chris Rice and I, 15, 20 years ago, tried to do this. And the council this time pushed it right through and have supported all of you guys. So I want to really thank the city council. I know some of them are still around here. And we've got to keep going. We've got to keep your interest. Get on the Facebook page that Amy and Dave have done such a great job with. And show up when we need you to show up. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Okay. So I'll let these guys close it down. But before I finish talking, I want to make sure that I know that I can't make everybody happy. I know that. Well, I want to make sure that I've got at least most of you guys happy. Are most of you guys happy with where we're going, what direction we've got?
Yes?
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, perfect. Thank you. I'll let these guys close it, and then I'll stick around for any more questions or comments.
I just want to say thank you to everyone for showing up tonight and giving your input. We really appreciate that. Again, please feel free to reach out to me. In fact, just sitting here thinking, we might be able to set up a project page on our recreation home website too. So we'll see what we can do to make sure that the public is well informed and all this. And, we can't wait to meet up with Brad again and see what he unveils for us in the second time around. So thank you all very much, and we'll see you next time.